What's up guys, take the new video. In view today I'd like to do a little bit of a different comparison. So as you may know, the Tronsmart Halo 100 is around 130, 140 euros. So this big boy is almost 800. It's sometimes in sale for around 700. So it's a big price difference. But some of you viewers really want to see the comparison. And before we go to audio samples, I'd like to say a few things because maybe on the audio samples, the Tronsmart will sound more boomy or more bass performing, but this has more to do with its way of performing the bass on smaller volumes. And also because this speaker has a passive radiator, it doesn't need a lot of room to produce bass. So with the Rubion, the bass recording is a little bit difficulty because my room is also not like extremely big, but also the bass is getting so strong in a bigger room that recording it will be a difficulty, even with a good microphone. I really tried anything. So this audio samples will be more of a comparison about how the audio quality sounds. So not necessarily about bass performance, because Rubion does have more bass, but only in like big room scenarios. And the Tronsmart does win on smaller room occasions with the bass performance, but I yesterday tried it out outdoors, and I did notice that because it's focused on deep bass, the upper bass is a little bit falling behind when you're using it outdoors, in my opinion. Even with the custom EQ, you can maybe improve it a little bit. So both speakers I will put on EQs, they are set on default. So this one was on the Soundpool EQ when I unpacked it. And this one is on the Hi-Fi EQ, which is the normal default EQ. And then you also have an ambient EQ, which turn down the treble a bit. And you also have like an outdoor EQ, and that enhances the treble even a little bit more and actually reduces the bass. So I'm not sure why that is happening, because outdoor you do need a little bit more bass response to compensate with no walls or anything to produce the bass. So yeah, Hi-Fi EQ, Soundpool EQ, let's get started. As said before, the audio samples, both speakers do pretty well. And especially for the price, Tonesmod really has built something incredible, for my opinion. But I did notice that the sound quality of the Tonesmod Halo really is different per unit, because I have seen people complain about the treble being a little bit of a problem. Yeah, the treble has some harshness on max volume, but my unit does sound overall fine. And I also noticed some people complaining about the mid-tones falling behind. And yeah, I'm fine with it on the speaker, but I did notice that this is happening with many speakers of Tonesmod, that audio quality side is a little bit different in most units. But this is also something JBL even has, and also Sony and even Miva. It's just because you produce a lot of production, so a lot of products, there will be some difference in quality and overall tuning. This doesn't mean that it's a bad speaker. It's just some maybe sound a little bit better, some maybe sound a little bit worse. But overall, I do think that if you use an EQ or use the sound pulse EQ, the overall tuning, in my opinion, is fine. With Rubion speakers, it's a little bit different story, because they are so expensive. It also is mostly handmade. So you don't really see it now on the outside, but here's a small screenshot of how they say on the website how it looks from behind this fabric, but also this like black bar. It's a wood speaker, so this means the sound is also like more natural, but also it's just fuller sound. And this plastic material, and don't get me wrong, plastic housings can produce all right sound, but they do need passive radiators or even some extra sealment or thick plastic materials to compensate for it. With wood, you do get some more fuller sound, and also the overall build quality looks very good. And the speaker is heavy. It doesn't have a battery even, so just imagine if this speaker, like the M430, would have a battery, it would be a lot of heavy. And I would say that even though this handle is maybe not the strongest, I would say, so I don't use it, because this like leather stuff does come off a little bit if you use it too much. So I do prefer the way Tonesmod is doing it, so it's more strong like on the sides, but it is a little bit on a thin side. I would say it needs a little bit thicker, so you have a little bit more of a handle. But I do think that this approach is a little bit better than this one, because this slides a little bit, and then you can have problems with like tear off. That's also why it's pretty flat on my unit, because I don't use it. If I take the speaker away, I do it like this, or I really like put it away. So this part is a little bit of a downside about this one. It's pretty durable on this, but it just needs a little bit more of a thicker shell. So yeah, overall, both speakers cool. Audio side, of course, will be almost better. But I do think that a Tonesmod for a lot lower price does give you some quality in audio, but not necessarily in build quality. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and see you guys.